600T, it's a rear-wheel drive variant. The GS 350, rear-wheel drive or all-wheel drive, and also our GS 450H hybrid, rear drive only in that vehicle. So design-wise, the F Sport vehicles, of course, have their own look about them. So again, features this mesh insert grille. Similarly, you'll see the L shapes in the upper portion of the mesh, and then as you progress further down, you'll see Fs coming through in the design itself. Again, very aggressive style look to the front of the vehicle. Own unique wheels, 19-inch wheels, new design for the 2016 GS. And at the rear of the vehicle, also two rear spoiler standard on the vehicle. And you know, again, contributing. Oh, also F Sport badging, of course, also the side fenders and the trunk area. Inside the vehicle, F Sport vehicles have a similar look to them. The GS F Sport interior design, the F Sport steering wheel, perforated leather steering with the F Sport badge on there. Also, too, we make use of real aluminum trim. I can't get the pronunciation right, but I think it's Naguri, N-A-G-U-R-I, aluminum trim. So that accentuates the interior of the vehicle itself. Scuff plates unique to the GSF. And also the pedals in the vehicle as well. A little bit different for those who've been around from Lexus. We've changed up the design, so now it's more this linear design as opposed to before it had more like circular spots on there. So something different for the 2016 F Sports. And also F Sport GS has its unique design seats. F Sport seats in a GS are leather interior in that. Adaptive meter. So again, our LFA was kind of the pinnacle of what we could do. Everyone was wowed by the LFA speedometer because it actually moved to the side. The GSF, the GS F Sport, it does not. It is fixed there, but again, harkens to the inspiration of the LFA. Again, depending on the mode, sport mode, eco, it changes the overall look of the adaptive meter there. So as Brian mentioned, F Sport suspension tuning does occur. So it's going to be the front and rear springs, adaptive variable suspension dampening, and also the electric power steering has been modified for the F Sport vehicles. So, with the drive mode select, again, you know, as we rotate through, first and foremost, we have Eco, which, again, is about fuel efficiency. The Sport S mode, one turn to the right, it just has an impact on powertrain, so it goes from a non-linear response, gives you that more quick response, so when you step on the gas. Sport S Plus mode, again, is where everything happens. So it's going to affect powertrain, the adaptive variable suspension, so give you a more firm ride to the vehicle, and electric power steering and variable gear ratio steering will be impacted there. GS, like the GSF, does have that customized mode as well. So again, through the nav system, drivers can change things. You can see here, powertrain, we can have normal mode, eco, or power. That can then decide if I want sport for my adaptive variable suspension, if you like, you know, firmer ride. I can do normal for the electric power steering and eco for air conditioning. So again, allowing that driver owner to customize their GS F Sport. F Sport, the brakes are enhanced as well, utilizing 14-inch two-piece rotors with four piston calipers up front, and then the 12.2 with the single piston caliper in the rear. Rear-wheel drive GS F Sports have an 8-speed automatic transmission, so the 8-speed sport shift, direct shift SPDS. Utilizes GAI control, so again, similarly, as we're entering a turn, the vehicle is going to look at the G sensors and actually hold, downshift, hold that gear as you go through that turn, so there's no shifting of gears, which can kind of impact the fun-to-drive aspect, so when you come out of that turn,